In Moscow's Gorky Park, American culture blossoms.
Now, here's a package you'll flip over. A contemporary sofa, love seat, and three tables for $7.99. Style and savings. That's the Siemens package.
Come together at Great Adventure. Act it up when dreams take flight. Leaving time and cares behind you. Sharing magic till midnight.
Don't miss new Roaring Rapids, the wettest, wildest whitewater family adventure east of the Colorado. And when the stars come out, enjoy a money-saving discount after 4 p.m.
So come together at Great Adventure and share the magic till midnight.
Save $3.50 after 4 p.m. now through Labor Day.
Our record speaks for itself. Kaufman has given its customers quality broadlooms at exceptional prices for over 50 years. This record-breaking clearance Friday and Saturday is no exception. You'll find 12 great carpets that regularly sold for $10.99 to $12.99 a square yard, reduced to one incredibly low $6.99. Just for the record, come see the carpets on sale at $6.99. That's $6.99 a square yard Friday and Saturday at Kaufman, a name that's been carpet value since 1922.
That's Hollywood Tonight at 7:30.
Oh, Erica. I'm glad you're still here, dear.
I wouldn't want you to leave without my saying goodbye.
That was my friend, Millie, on the phone.
Oh, Millie?
Mm-hmm.
Listen, Mrs. Martin, your house guest was just telling me she doesn't think this picture does me justice. Do you agree?
Well, Erica, I don't think a photograph ever gives the entire personality of a vivacious person like you.
Oh, that is just the right way to put it. You are so clever.
Oh, well, I don't know about that.
Did Opal leave?
No, she went upstairs to get her daughter to bring her down to meet me. I mean, I guess she has some kind of delusions that her daughter is going to be a model someday.
Well, she's a very, very beautiful young lady.
Really? Mrs. Martin, I never understood exactly why they are staying here.
Well, they came to see Ted, of course.
Tad?
Yeah, Ruth and Joe's Tad. And, oh, Erica, if they had just come a few weeks earlier, I think things would have turned out so differently. I'm sure Tad would never run away.
Tad Gardner?
Well, it's Tad Martin now. Ruth and Joe legally adopted him, dear.
Ah, well, but he is still Ray Gardner's son, and that is Ray Gardner's wife, and that is Ray Gardner's daughter she is bringing down here to meet me.
Well, but...
I mean, hey, that horrible Ray Gardner, well, no way am I staying here to meet those people. I'm not going to have anything to do with his family. Hello, Sean.
What are you doing here?
I came by to visit my mother.
Cook tells me she's feeling better.
That's right, she is. I don't suppose you'd ever go up to the third floor to see for yourself, would you?
Why should I when I can get reports from the other domestic help? Besides, your mother's a tough old bird. We'd have to shoot her to get rid of her.
You wouldn't by any chance be talking about Palmer's missing gun, would you?
I was just kidding, Daisy.
Were you? What about this morning, Sean? Were you kidding then, too? When you said that we shouldn't see each other anymore?
I think it would be best for both of us, okay?
Best? I know what's best for me, and it's not to make love with somebody all night and then to be cast aside in the morning. You're not going to get rid of me that easily.
Don't you think you'd better visit your mother?
Yes, I'm going. But when I come downstairs, you and I are going to talk. You're not going to get rid of me so easily.
Good morning, Doctor.
Morning.
Oh, there you are, Cliff. How's Mrs. Werblin?
Well, with the temperature she was spiking, I thought maybe she had an infection after the operation. No, she's doing fine.
Oh, good, good. I felt the same thing, too. Since you operated on her, I thought you ought to come and take a look at her.
Cliff, listen, I'm sorry that I called you at home. I know you haven't had much time off.
No, I'm glad you called. I had to see her. Besides, when you called, I was on my way somewhere, and you're making me come here probably stop me from committing murder.
Miss Thorne, wake up and let me in. Miss Thorne, I know you're in there asleep. I called the operator. She told me the phone was off the hook. It's the middle of the morning, for heaven's sakes. Open.
What's brand new in a carton has five fruit juices and is so refreshing.
Yeah?
Makes you say, wow.
I give up.
It's new Five Alive in a carton with 60% real juice from five delicious fruits. Tangerine, lemon, grapefruit, lime, and orange.
What do you think?
Very refreshing.
He forgot to say wow.
Wow.
Snow Crop Five Alive, the all-natural refresher, now in the freezer and dairy case.
You can bridge the miles between you and your loved ones with professional photographic portraits taken at Sears. Trust Sears Portrait Studio to create the quality portraits you want to save and share. This week, Tuesday through Saturday only, Sears offers a package of 2 8x10, 3 5x7, 15 wallet size, and 3 portrait charms for only $14.95, including 95-cent deposit. Share a memory with a portrait from Sears today.
People are talking about the great taste of Vlasic pickles like never before.
Here, my dear, try a Vlasic pickle.
Why, thank you, dear. Now, that's the best tasting pickle I ever heard.
Hey, Jimmy, want a trade?
Sure. Want a Vlasic pickle?
Okay.
Now, that's the best tasting pickle I ever heard.
Vlasic pickles. Try them and you might say...
今までにない美味しいのピクルを聞きました.
All in love, all over again, with the sizzling summer romance that started it all. She is a castaway. She and the boy who is now a man. She watches him, and something inside her stirs. Columbia Pictures presents a sensuous story of natural love starring Brooke Shields and introducing Christopher Atkins in The Blue Lagoon, rated R. Check newspapers for a theater near you.
Anyway, Mrs.
Just
Martin.
A minute, Erica. You are not leaving yet.
Mrs. Martin, you can't expect me to stay here around those people.
If I can have them in my home, you can spare them a few minutes of your time.
But, Mrs. Martin, Ray Gardner was so awful to you. I mean, that is his wife and that is his daughter. He was so awful to all of you, especially to Ruth. I mean, I don't know how you can have them in your house.
Erica, the sins of the fathers are not visited on the children.
But he...
You listen to me. If you leave here before Jenny comes down, you will never be welcome in my home again.
Mrs. Martin, I can't believe that you are speaking to me that way.
I mean exactly what I say. And if you are not civil...
Here we are.
Oh, here they are.
Miss Kane, this is my daughter, Jenny. Jenny, say hello to Miss Kane.
It's just about you, Mama.
Well, what do you think, Miss Kane? Isn't she just a beauty? Well, yes, she certainly is. Wouldn't you say that she just about has it hands down over most of those girls who are modeling professionally today?
Mama, please. Don't be embarrassed, Jenny. Why, beauty is this woman's business. Miss Kane is an American beauty.
We can't ask advice of somebody like her. How are we ever going to find out how to get ahead in this business? Wouldn't you just say that my daughter has it all, Miss Kane?
Well, of course, I don't know as much about this as Erica does, naturally, but I do know that Jenny is a beautiful, beautiful young lady. But I also think that she should finish her high school first before she even thinks of a career in modeling. Don't you agree, Opal?
Oh, of course, but I always say there's nothing like being prepared, if you know what I mean. Miss Kane, don't a lot of girls a lot younger than Jenny, like, go to these professional schools and model at the same time? You must know some of them, don't you?
No, I don't know any of them personally. I know that it happens.
Yeah. Well, listen, I was thinking that maybe you could give us some names of some people to look up when we get down to New York City who might be able to give us some help.
I don't really know. I don't know anyone.
Oh, come now, Miss Kane. Surely you must know some people that could give us some help.
Well, are you planning to go to New York soon, Hope?
Oh, well, not right away, Miss Martin, but I do intend to get there as soon as I can get things ready. You know, would you give me your phone number now, Miss Kane? I'll just write it on the back of this magazine here.
Well, I just had my phone number changed. Gee, I can't remember my new number.
Oh, well, I guess I'll just have to get it from information then.
No, you couldn't do that because my number is unlisted. It has to be, otherwise so many people call, you know.
Mama, don't bother Miss Kane, please don't. What a thing to say, Jenny. Am I bothering you, Miss Kane?
No, you're not bothering me. No. No, it's just that I really don't know my phone number, and I don't know how you could get in touch with me.
Well, Erica, I've got an idea. When Opal and Jenny go to New York, by that time I'm sure your mother will have your phone number, won't she?
Well, could be.
Mm-hmm. Well, in that case, then, when the time comes, I can just call Mona and get your number, and then Opal can call you.
Well, thank you very much, Miss Martin. That's exactly how we'll work it out. And I want to thank you for being so kind, too, Miss Kane.
Oh, no trouble at all. Now I really must go.
Miss Kane.
Nice to have met you.
Yes, Miss Kane. You know, I think you're even more beautiful than any of your pictures.
Why, thank you. That's very nice of you to say.
And I must say, I did enjoy reading the article about you, Miss Mike.
Oh, that article is full of inaccuracies.
You mean all those stories about you and that man who owns that cosmetic company?
Yes, they are terrible lies. Listen, I've really got to go. Goodbye again. Goodbye, Mrs. Martin.
Bye.
Goodbye, dear.
Miss Thorne! Miss Thorne, open this door at once!
Okay! I'm coming! Don't knock my door down.
Good morning, Mr. Portman.
What are you, a descendant of Rip Van Winkle?
Who?
Oh, never mind. I have never known anyone to sleep so soundly.
It's easy when you're tired.
No, tired from staying up all night debauching?
I was discoing.
Don't play dumb with me. You know exactly what I meant.
Okay, okay. Oh, would you like some grapefruit juice?
No, thank you. I want to know what happened between you and Nina yesterday.
You mean Shawnee Pooh didn't tell you word for word what I told him? Listen, he saw Nina, too. You must have a bigger picture of the whole thing than I do.
I'm interested in accuracy, not size.
What did he tell you?
Well, he was very optimistic about his meeting with Nina. He felt that she would ask Warner for a divorce.
Yeah, well, that's exactly what he told me.
But she didn't say that she really would do it.
What do you want her to do, swear in a stack of Bibles?
See, what worries me is it'll be just too much for Nina. She's a very fragile and high-strung girl. Well, I'm just afraid of what it might lead herself to do. I don't know.
You don't mean that she... Oh, come
Look,
on.
Did you say anything to her that would put her into an acute depression?
Look, she loves the guy. That's what you based your master plan on, isn't it? Well, I followed your plan to the letter. Plain and simple. I said, if you don't divorce Cliff, I'll take Bobby away, give him up for adoption to strangers, and Cliff will never see his son again. Isn't that what you wanted to say?
Yes.
Okay, then. Oh, my head is killing me. I guess Sean did a better job on her. I mean, he told her how Cliff was worried about losing his son in the years to come.
So, you really feel that Nina won't tell Warner the whole story?
If she had, I would have heard from Cliff by now.
Yes, I suppose you would have at that.
So, you get your wish.
Yes, and you'll get yours in time, Miss Thorne. As soon as Nina gets a quick divorce from Dr. Warner, he'll turn to the mother of his child. I predict he'll marry you within 6 months.
I'll bet Sean beats me to the altar with Nina.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, come on. Don't play bright-eyed innocent with me. I already told you. I know the other half of your plan. It's for Nina to marry Sean. And now I'm even more certain than ever that he wants to share her life and her money.
I don't know what to say.
Well, thank heavens Nina was truthful with you.
Well, Chuck, I practically had to shake it out of her. Really, she went on and on about how she didn't want the responsibility of marriage anymore. She wanted to be free. She even brought up buying the new house as a good reason to see that she made a mistake.
Well, if you know Nina better than believe any of that, you know that she loves you.
Well, thank God I did know that, Chuck. I'm telling you, I was shaky there for a while. She put on quite an act. The thing that infuriates me about this, though, is that Sybil could be so cruel as to put Nina through all that. I was about to go over there when you called.
Cliff, listen. I think it's a good idea for you to try to calm down before you even try to talk to
Sybil. I'm calm, and I am going to talk to Sybil as soon as she comes into this hospital.
I hate to tell you this, but I talked to Betsy. It's Sybil's day off today.
Oh? No, maybe that's better. No, I'll go to her apartment. Yeah, then we'll have a nice private little conversation face to face. I'm telling you, this is a day Sybil Thorne is not going to forget for the rest of her life.
Wonderful salad dressing. How do you do it?
That's my secret.
Oh, Mom.
Shh. That's my secret.
Hidden Valley Ranch.
This is Ranch Original. I just add milk and mayonnaise. It makes up so rich and creamy.
It's unique, Kathy, just like you.
Delicious.
See? A secret this good is worth keeping.
Shh. Ranch Original and our newest Vintage Herb from Hidden Valley Ranch. Unique flavors.
Secret recipes.
Shh.
Boy, are you going to get it now.
What?
Look at that greasy mess you made. And Mom just drove up.
Give me something fast.
Here, 409 works fast.
Yeah?
Before you start to wind.
409 special grease dissolvers cut through grease fast.
Hurry!
409 is so effective, it starts to work before you start to wipe.
Hey, that shines. What have you two been up to?
Mm-hmm.
Formula 409. It starts to work before you start to wipe.
I've got it, Janie. I've got it.
You've got it, all right. You've got ring around the column.
Janie! It's true. I tried sprays, powders, and they weren't good enough.
Now try Whisk.
Whisk does a better job on ring around the collar. And Whisk goes on to get your whole wash clean.
Hi. I'm sorry I said that, Gerald. Mom said you did us a favor. No more ring around the collar. Come on.
Whisk gets ring around the collar and your whole wash clean.
There is a land of promise, a land of sun and showers. And in that land of promise, we grow our golden sunflowers.
The natural goodness of sunflower oil is in every bite of Promise margarine.
Promise tastes fresh and light.
And sunflower oil is high in polyunsaturates and has no cholesterol.
There is a land of promise, a land of golden sunflowers.
Well, I would say that this was just about our lucky day, wouldn't you, Jenny? Meet Miss Erica Kane like that?
Oh, yes, Mama.
And we owe you a great debt of thanks, Miss Martin. I mean, having such important friends like that, that's really wonderful. How long have you known Miss Kane?
Oh, I've known Erica since high school days.
You hear that, baby? You hear what Miss Martin just said?
Yes, Mama, I heard.
Someday everybody's going to be saying that about you. They're going to be saying, I knew Jenny Gardner when she was just in high school.
Oh, well, I've just got to say something.
Well, sure, Miss Martin. Go ahead. Speak your mind.
Please don't hurry too much into this modeling career for Jenny. Just don't push.
This is a dog-eat-dog world, Miss Martin. You don't push. You don't get no fun.
Well, what I mean to say is don't rush Jenny through her childhood. Let her enjoy her senior year in high school. She'll be young such a short time. And there are plenty of years ahead to be modeled.
But a model's career don't last that long, Miss Martin. And it's now, when Jenny is young and beautiful, that we got to make the most of it. Surely you can understand that.
Well, all I'm trying to say is that I think Jenny's happiness and her right to a normal life are far more important than fame or fortune. And surely you, as her mother, must agree with me in that.
Yes,
I agree with you, Miss Martin. I couldn't agree with you more.
Well, very happy to hear that. And now I shall go in and finish the breakfast dishes.
I'll help you, Miss Martin. Jenny,
did you forget that Mama made a dentist appointment for you for today, baby?
I guess I did, Mama.
Very important to see a dentist every 6 months, don't you think, Miss Martin? That's right. Now, don't worry, Jenny. There are very few dishes left, but I thank you for your offer.
Okay. Mama, you didn't make any dentist appointment for me.
I know it. I told you we were going back to Foxy's to get your job back.
I don't want to work there.
Would you hush up, please? I'm the one who decides what you're going to do, what you're not going to do. I don't want you paying attention to Miss Martin, either. She doesn't know anything about this business. You're already a lot older than I'd like you to be to get started. But before I'm finished with you, baby, you're going to be even more famous than that snooty beauty, Erica Kane.
Yes?
Tom, hi. Listen, I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
As a matter of fact, I was just on my way to work.
Well, I just couldn't be in Pine Valley without stopping in to see you. And Brooke, there you are. Hi. Nice to see you again.
Hello, Erica.
Well, listen, when I heard you were in town, I just had to stop by. Brooke, I had to tell you how sorry I am. How I was to hear about what happened with your mother.
Thank you.
Well, I mean, my goodness, it must have been really something to hear that your own mother was the head of an international drug ring. I mean, I guess she was getting ready to kill you or something?
Erica, that is all in the past. Brooke would rather not be reminded of it.
Oh, Tom, how naive can you be? I bet it's on Brooke's mind every moment of every day and every night.
Well, it certainly doesn't help to have people talking about it.
Tom, I was just trying to sympathize with Brooke. My goodness, you're unfeeling.
I am.
It's all right, Tom. Erica, thank you for your sympathy. But as Tom said, I'd really rather not talk about something so unpleasant.
Yes, well, I certainly know how you feel. I mean, that's another reason that... All right, I guess that you already have read the article on me in Tempo magazine.
No, we didn't.
You didn't? Well, how could you miss it? I'm on the cover.
We don't take Tempo.
You don't?
No.
Well, okay, well, I have a copy here, so I'll leave it for you, but just don't believe anything you read about my personal life.
Oh, well, I know how Tempo tends to exaggerate. Go for the jugular, as we say in journalism circles.
No, well, of course, they're right about my success. But you see, they said that Brandon Kingsley's wife has won out, and that's not true at all. Brandon and I are going to be married just as soon as the divorce comes through.
Best wishes, Erica.
Well, thank you, Brooke. Thank you very much. Brandon and I are very, very much in love, and I know that we are going to be very, very happy. It's just that I didn't want you to believe what they say. There is not going to be a reconciliation between Brandon and that monster he has been married to for all these horrible years.
Yes, well, I certainly know how unhappy a man can be married to the wrong woman.
No, Tom, you can't compare... You have never met anyone like Sarah Kingsley in your entire life. And Brandon has been miserable for 20 years.
Well, if that's true, Erica, he should have ended his marriage a long time ago. Smart men do.
Well, that's just because he hadn't met me yet. He hadn't met anybody important enough to go through all the trauma.
I see. Well, I do have to get back to the goalpost to get things squared away. You do understand?
Yes, of course, I understand completely. Oh, speaking of which... Do you still have Wally working for you?
He's my right-hand man.
Was he working out his dilemma?
His what?
Oh, Tom, come on. Don't pretend with me. I know that he's in love with Betsy Kennicott. Betsy confided that to me.
Erica, that is a damn lie.
Tom, I am not lying.
Well, then you're bending the truth way out of line. Now, Betsy would never confide anything like that to you, and I know that for a fact. I know what happened, Erica. You ought to be horsewhipped for it.
When the surgical residents, please report.
Betsy?
Oh, hi, Cliff. One minute.
Darling, would you have Bill check on Mr. Horning for me? Thanks a lot. Hi, Cliff. What can I do for you?
Is it true Sybil isn't coming in today?
Yeah, according to the schedule. Is there something I can do for you?
No, this is between me and Sybil.
Hey, Cliff, is something wrong?
Oh, you bet there is. I'm telling you, your ex-roommate is going to be sorry she ever tangled with me.
Cliff, what are you talking?
I can't talk about it. I gotta go.
Yeah. Bye, Cliff.
Medical conference now beginning in fourth floor conference.
Hello there.
Medical conference now beginning.
Hi, Rick.
Listen, I got an extra long lunch hour today. How about letting me take you to that little Italian restaurant in the corner?
I don't have a long lunch hour.
And I'm getting some extra cold vibes, aren't I?
Yes, you are.
Well, how come?
As if you didn't know. Telling Devin McFadden that I was involved with her husband. Rick, how could you do such a thing? How could you?
A Bun Brand cake mix is a fresh way to show you care.
It's flowers, more than a kiss. The place of a hug for someone to miss.
Only a bun cake has its own luscious filling that bakes right inside. It says more than words ever could.
Instead of a call,
take someone a bunch of
love.
For no reason at all, the freshest ideas are baking at Pillsbury.
We're going to have to tell Susan and Linda and
think all these years we told everyone to use this mayonnaise.
Nobody's perfect, Harriet.
Without even considering Kraft real mayonnaise.
There, there, dear.
After all, Kraft is rich with eggs and specially blended over 3,000 times for creamy smoothness.
Looks creamier than ours.
Well, Martha, now we know better.
And Cousin May in Topeka.
Oh, don't tell her.
Creamy Kraft real mayonnaise. Now you know.
I have a tension headache. Feels like someone is compressing my brain.
Would you try extra strength Tylenol? You can't buy a more potent pain reliever without a prescription.
I have to see what it does for me.
Look at the difference in the amount of medicine in the leading pain relievers.
Extra strength Tylenol has more pain reliever. I have to try it. No pain, no pressure. Extra strength Tylenol is a super product.
Try extra strength Tylenol, aspirin free, and you can't buy a more potent pain reliever without a prescription.
Now is the time, ABC is the place.
This is the Hollister family, dominated by wealthy Aunt Louisa, mistress of their hidden past.
Your father always said that you'd come back begging one day.
With secrets her niece is determined to uncover.
Pastor.
Secrets that could destroy them all.
What if she starts remembering?
King's Crossing, a small town hiding a mysterious past, this fall.
Saturday is the night, ABC.
Why do you insist on this ridiculous theory of yours?
Because it happens to be true. No matter how you try to deny it. You just don't want Nina divorced from Cliff Warner. You want her married to Sean Cuddy. And I guess he wants it even more than you do.
Well, I've already told you. Sean is more suitable to Nina than Dr. Warner.
And Sean couldn't agree with you more. He's already confessed as much.
Just what has he said to you?
Oh, you don't have to worry. Very complimentary. And why shouldn't it be? Sean Cudahy has dollar signs for eyeballs.
Sean is an astute young man. Fine business head. He's shown that very clearly while he's been working for me.
Yeah, I bet he has. I think the whole thing is nifty dandy. I wish them luck and happiness forever and ever. I just hope you're not sorry, Mr. Gordon.
Sorry? Why would you make a statement like that?
I don't know if you'll be so pleased with Sean Cudahy for a son-in-law after all. He's playing up to you. The fact is, you and he are too much alike.
Well, I don't consider you to be exactly a fine judge of character, Miss Thorne.
Maybe not. I hope I'm wrong. I hope Sean makes you both so happy you can't see straight.
Good day, Miss Thorne.
Hold it! I want to talk to you about a little matter.
What matter?
Money, the balance you owe me.
I told you you'd get your money when Nina got her divorce.
I won't need it then as much as I do now. When Cliff comes to me for tender, loving comfort. I want to have a wardrobe that'll knock his socks off, not clothes that are 2 years old.
Yes, I get your point.
So, where is it?
Well, for heaven's sakes, you don't think I carry $5,000 on my person?
With zillionaires like you, anything is possible.
Well, I can assure you I don't. I'll have to go to the bank, make a withdrawal.
Today?
Yes, sometime today. I can't tell you exactly when.
Good. I'll be home all day today. You just give me a call first. I wouldn't want you to run into Cliff.
Neither would I.
Oh, Mr. Cortland. Don't forget that little stop at the bank.
Don't worry. I shan't. Is your mother?
She's doing just fine.
That's good to hear.
So I thought this might be a very good time for us to continue our conversation.
Well, there's nothing more to say.
I've got a whole lot inside me to say to you. You can't just throw me away like I was garbage.
Will you be quiet, please? Mr. Cortland could hear you.
No, good try. I already checked on that. And the cook assures me that he has gone out.
Well, he's due back any minute.
Well, good. Then we'll just stand right here and watch his car drive up out that window, won't we?
Shouldn't you be at the serving spoon right now?
Gary Sanders is covering for me, so now you can stop changing the subject. I want to know, Sean. Who is she?
Who is who?
Who is that woman that you are trying to get rid of me for?
There isn't anybody.
You said this morning that there was.
Well, I only said that to make the break easier.
Easier?
I think when something is over, we should recognize it, Daisy.
Well,
I always said I don't want any strings attached. Now, you knew this day was coming along.
Yes, I did know. Just not now. Not now, because I can't live my life without you now.
Would you please stop with your dramatics?
I'm serious, Sean. You can't treat me like this and get away with it. You try it. And I will go to Palmer and tell him everything.
You what?
Yes. I'll tell him that you know that I am really Daisy Cortland.
The first of the great man's wives. He's always wanted to know who my mystery lover is. Well, you know, I think I'll go out to that library right now and sit down on that couch and I'll wait for him to come home and satisfy his curiosity once and for all.
You wouldn't dare. No, you wouldn't dare.
Oh, wouldn't I? Try me.
My children will continue in a moment.
Spray and wash gets out what America gets into. Spray and wash gets out what America gets into.
Italian Wash has gotten out more food, grease, and dirt than any other stain remover. So try our non-aerosol trigger and our economy squeeze bottle.
Spray and wash gets out what America gets into.
If your husband's plain, uncoated white plate just sprung a leak, make a fuss. And the next time, give him a Dixie printed plate. It won't soak through.
Dixie helps you do more for the people you care for.
When it's lunch on the run, don't you miss out on the fun. Give him Dixie printed plates, the prettiest plates you'll never wash.
Dixie helps you do more
for the people you care for.
Look, America, Wesson's got a brand new look.
New bottle.
Easy grip bottle. Easy to hold, easy to pour.
Easy on me.
Look, Wesson's got a brand new look.
Feel it looks lighter.
25% lighter.
Terrific.
Look, Wesson's...
I know Wesson's got a brand new look, and my fried chicken tastes...
So come on, America, get new, lighter Wesson in the easy grip bottle.
Envelope stuffing, easy money at home or a rip-off, tonight on 2020.
Package yourself a good night's sleep. For only $8.99, Siemens gives you 8 contemporary pieces. Value and savings, that's what you get in the Siemens package.
In 1929, Paramount Poultry began selling their first premium-priced chicken. But not everybody bought the idea.
Sure, the chickens cost more, but I bring my Paramount chickens in fresh every day. I feed them special. I handle them special. I even name them special. See? Paramount.
Yeah, but will people pay more?
For over 50 years, people have been paying more for Paramount chickens because good taste has always been worth more.
If there's one job I hate, it's scrubbing the toilet. And you know what? I don't do it anymore. There's this different kind of chemical system. 2,000 flushes. Keeps the water crystal clear. Keeps the bowl sparkling clean continuously for about 4 months. No rings, no streaks, no stains. Just put the container in your tank and forget it. Every time you flush, the chlorine crystals dissolve away rust and minerals before dirt rings and stains appear. 2,000 flushes keeps the bowl so sparkling clean, I don't scrub at all. And flushing sure beats brushing.
Roseanne Scamardella on Eyewitness News at 11.
You're denying that there's something between Wally and Betsy.
I am denying. Look, I know that you tricked Betsy into admitting that there was something between them.
I did not trick her. Mark told me about it.
No, he did not. Now, Wally told me that you overheard a conversation at the goalpost between him and Mark. And then your suspicious mind just kept on working until you had to go over to Betsy's and pull one of your numbers on her.
Yes, I mean, I really don't have to stand here and listen to this kind of talk.
Nobody asked you to come here in the first place.
I came out of the kindness of my heart.
No. No, you came because you wanted us to see that you were written up in Tempo magazine. And then you just couldn't help yourself. You had to get into some gossip. Erica, isn't there enough trouble in the world without you trying to stir up more?
Goodbye, Brooke. Bye-bye, Erica.
Wait a minute. Take your magazine with you.
You know what I think, Tom? I think you're jealous that you're not in this magazine with me.
Get out of here.
Tom, don't let her get to you that way.
I know I shouldn't. I don't like the way she talks to you.
Erica doesn't bother me. Really, she doesn't, honey. I just hope she keeps quiet about Wally and Betsy.
Yeah, so do I.
Tom, is it true?
Yeah. Honey, I'm sorry. I just didn't feel that I should say anything to anybody, including you.
No. Of course you shouldn't have. I understand that.
You know, Devin and Wally could have made their marriage work. I'm sure they could have if it hadn't been for my egomaniacal brother putting the make on Devin.
Yes. And then when he dropped her, she started drinking.
Wally's a good guy, but even he can only take so much. His wife goes off to a sanitarium to get herself dried out. Betsy moves in to take care of Bonnie. I don't know, Brooke. I think it was only natural for them to be drawn together.
Yeah, probably. Does Devin know about
this? No.
No, I don't think she does know. I just hope and pray she never has to find out.
There's nothing else for us to talk about, Rick.
Will you hear me out? You gotta know I'd never deliberately tell Devin McFadden or anybody else that you were interested in a married guy. She was the one who said it.
Oh, come on.
Will you let me tell you what happened?
Yeah, okay.
Sybil introduced us at the hospital cafeteria, and then Sybil left.
Why didn't you leave with her?
I didn't know Devin McFadden even knew you. You see, she thought I was going out with Sybil. And I said, I'm really more interested in someone that used to be Sybil's roommate. So she immediately figured that that was you, of course. Now, I made a mistake when I said I wasn't getting very far with you because you were interested in another guy. But I never would have gone any further than that.
Then why did you?
Because old Devin acted like she knew all about it. And then she asked me if I knew this guy was married.
Oh.
I can see now that she was just fishing around. She was trying to find something out. And I wish I would have kept my mouth shut. But she was convincing. I didn't know until right now that this guy in question was her husband. And you gotta believe that.
I do, Rick. It's just that it's all so awful.
What, did Devin confront you with this? Is that it?
Yeah. I wanted to die.
Well, listen, I know that this is none of my business. But what did happen?
I told her that I hoped that she and Wally could work things out. And, Rick, I really mean that.
Yeah, I know you do. You're too good a person to get mixed up in something like this.
Rick, nothing happened between Wally and me.
No. I know. What I mean is you shouldn't be suffering like this. You got a face that... You got a face that should be always smiling. Not tears in your eyes. Forgive me?
Yes.
Enough to go to a movie with me tonight? only a movie and a little pizza afterwards. No big deal. Okay.
Okay. And thank you, huh? I'm really sorry I got so angry.
As long as it's got a happy ending. That's what I care about.
Daisy, be reasonable.
My whole life doesn't seem very reasonable right now, the way you're treating me.
But it would be bad for you, too, if you told Palmer about us.
Why? Why? Not if you're going to leave me anyway. And if you're going to make me suffer, then I am going to make you suffer right along with me.
Jenny's hair is such a lovely color. She gets it from you.
Of course. Actually, I get mine from Miss Claro. I get the soft, lovely color and touch I had when I was younger. Very much like Jenny's, with no trace of gray. And only Miss Claro has color hold conditioner.
You know, younger looking hair makes quite a difference.
Mm, and how I look and feel about myself.
Miss Claro, because it's nice to look younger than you are.
Last cold contact, this cold, Comtrex. Comtrex relieves more of my cold symptoms.
Last cold Dristan, this cold, Comtrex. Comtrex does more. It even relieves my cough.
Instead of these for their nasal congestion, runny nose, aches, fever, and coughs, they've switched to Comtrex Multi-Symptom Cold Reliever. All by itself, it gives more kinds of relief than Dristan or Contac or Bayer. This cold, Comtrex, in tablets, liquid, and now capsules.
My friend Billy here is a legend. He's conquered every fence, tree, and vacant lot on the block. But in Levi's jeans, there my old pals met his match. Turn around, Billy. Since 1850, Levi's jeans have lived through everything from bucking broncos to bicycle sprockets to Billy. Right. Levi's jeans in denim or corduroy. Because a legend does not come apart at the seams.
It's stew time, it's stew time. The chuck wagon's coming. A hearty stew like meal. The brains dogs are running. It's chuck wagon dog food made to feed like a stew. Its pieces are coated with real meat juices too.
Chuck wagon. Hearty beef, chicken, and vegetable flavors coated with real meat juices. And give your dog that great taste of stew he loves in every bite.
It's stew time, it's stew time. The chuck wagon's due. It's bringing dogs a running for that great taste of stew.
Daisy, baby, don't be this way.
I can't help it. I'm just reacting to the way you're being. I can't take it anymore.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I guess I was insensitive.
You guess.
I was, definitely. But it's just, I was afraid Palmer was going to find out about us, and that's why I said that we shouldn't see each other.
Why? What could he possibly do to you, even if he found out?
Maybe nothing, but maybe a lot. But this is not the place to talk about it.
No, I... Then you come to my place.
I want to.
Come sometime today.
I don't know.
Please, I won't wait long because I don't believe anything you say to me.
Okay. I want to. And you're going to be home all day, right? You're not working all day?
No. Carrie is taking the serving spoon all day.
Okay. Then I'll come today.
Lunch?
I don't know yet about lunch. Palmer might need me at lunch, but I tell you what, as soon as he gets back, I'll call you and I'll let you know.
Do you mean that?
I swear to you. Now you just go home and you wait for me and I'll call.
All right. Yes.
Okay.
All right. You know, I think I'll stop by Nina's on my way home.
No, don't.
Why not? This is the day that they're moving into their new house.
I know. That's why you shouldn't bother.
I don't bother Nina. I'm a help to her.
No, I know you don't, but just in case I can get away sooner for an early lunch, then that way you'll be there when I call.
Yes, of course, all right. But you be sure you call.
You know I will, okay?
Okay, Sean.
Thank you, Hughes. I put the car in the garage myself.
What are you doing here?
Well, I came to visit my mother. What else?
Well, go see her and be gone.
I already have, thanks for your hospitality.
Just a moment. What excuse did you give Donna for being here?
Well, I didn't happen to see the second Mrs. Cortland. I think she's upstairs with Bobby.
Just a moment. I assume from your being at liberty at this time of day that you've sold your place of business?
You may assume no such thing.
Well, don't you assume that my patience will last very long. I've told you what would happen to you if you didn't get out of sight and out of town. In fact, I've just been visiting the kennels to inspect my Dobermans. They're getting hungrier.
I'm telling you, you sick those monsters on me, and my mama will unmask you for just who you are.
Not if your mama is also one of their victims.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good morning, Mrs. Jeanville.
Good morning.
There were some phone messages while you were out, sir. I thought you'd want to see them right away.
Thank you, Sean. Well, good day, Mr. Jeanville. She loves to play the gracious lady, visiting the sick among her neighbor's servants.
Oh, is that why she was here?
Yes, but two more important matters. I think you know where I've just been.
To see Sybil Thorne?
Yes, and it was a very interesting visit.
Were you satisfied that Nina will act according to our plan?
Which was originally your plan, Sean.
But you endorsed it completely, sir.
True. However, I did not know that you would tell Sybil what you hoped to gain from it all.
I don't know what you're...
Not only her desire for Dr. Warner, but your designs on Nina.
Mr. Coyle and I assure you that Sybil's suspicious mind at work. I said nothing of the sort to her.
Yes, well, this is the second time she's mentioned it. She knows you well, Sean.
I do believe that you admitted the truth of it to her.
All I admitted to Sybil was that I do have a deep and sincere love for Nina. And that I would be the happiest man in the world if she would consider being my wife.
Yes, of course. Oh, come on now. Don't be so flustered.
Well, there for a minute, you seemed to think that I was some sort of opportunist.
Oh, no, no, of course. Well, Sybil Thorne, of course, thinks that you are, but I don't know. Now, since Nina has confided so totally in you, why don't you go see her again?
Today?
Yes, just in case she's having second thoughts. She may be wavering. I'm sure you could keep her firm in her resolve to end her marriage.
Of course, but I think I should telephone first.
Please. By all means.
This Sunday's paper has coupons good for savings up to $3 on General Foods brands. Like Maxwell House Instant, Bird's Eye Vegetables, Cycle. For every coupon you redeem by September 30th, General Foods will donate 5 cents to the Muscular Dystrophy Association. Up to $1 million to fight muscular dystrophy and help save Jerry's kids.
Save a little something for yourself and my kids.
Look for coupons in this Sunday's paper.
Okay, is everybody ready to play Simon Says?
Yeah!
Simon Says, eat some smooth, creamy Jell-O pudding. Mmm. Simon Says, take a spoonful of Jell-O pudding, but don't eat it. Okay, Simon Says, eat it.
Kids love Jell-O brand pudding, and because you make it with fresh milk, you know it's wholesome.
And now, Simon Says, give me your Jell-O pudding.
No!
Since 1977, tuna fish is up 36%.
Holy mackerel.
Swiss cheese, 36%.
Well, that's on America.
Peanut butter, 97%.
Oh, nuts.
Today, when it costs a small fortune just to make a small sandwich, you need Ziploc sandwich bags. With their unique seal, Ziploc bags are a zip to lock, and they stay locked. So sandwiches stay fresher and neater. Chicken salad's up 37%.
That's despicable.
Ziploc sandwich bags. There's no better way to protect your investment.
On One Life to Live.
You'll be the last thing on my mind when I make a decision.
But I will take legal action if you try and take Mary anywhere.
Where she lives, that's my decision.
If you try and take Mary away from me, I'll stop you dead in your tracks.
And on General Hospital.
Look at her, Robert. She's delirious.
It's Laura's life and death struggle on the island of mystery.
Nothing is working. The fever isn't breaking. She could die.
One Life to Live, General Hospital. Weekdays.
Let it ring 10 times.
Not there, unfortunately.
Perhaps she's not answering the phone. In case Cliff might try to call.
Good thinking. Sean, why don't you go over there anyway without calling?
Oh, I don't know about that, Mr. Cole.
Well, just tell her that you phoned and there was no answer and you were worried about her. Not that I think she's vacillating, but it wouldn't hurt for you to go over there and give her a little moral support.
Perhaps Nina would think it odd that I'm being so persistent.
But you're her friend. She knows that.
Indeed I am, sir, but wouldn't it be rather awkward if Cliff stopped by and found me there?
She must have told him by now. Nina said she'd get back to me this morning. Why hasn't she called? Maybe something went wrong. Of course not. It was just that wild Palmer Cortland coming over here. He gives me the creeps. If anyone would mess this thing up, it would be him. He can't keep his nose out of anything. Oh, call. Somebody call. Cliff is bound to have left for the hospital a long time ago. I can't wait anymore. I've got to call Nina. she? Where can she be? Why hasn't she called me? It's waiting, driving me nuts.
If his temperature remains normal, I'd like to remove that drainage catheter this afternoon. Can you inform me on that?
Yes, doctor.
Also, I told Mrs. Kirkpatrick that she could go home today. Call her family. I'm sure she's a little forgetful.
Okay, if she hasn't, I will.
Well, it's certainly good to have Nurse Kennicott back with us.
Yes, it is. Oh, listen, have you heard any news from Sybil today?
No, and that's fine with me.
From the sound of it, you two are no longer friends.
Yeah, you might say so.
Sounds like Sybil's losing friends in droves.
Have you talked to Sybil yet?
No, I haven't had a free moment since I saw you last. But believe me, I still plan to see her face to face.
You know, it's hard to believe that Sybil would do something like this.
Yes, it is. Only I'm not so sure she did this alone. I sense Palmer Cortland's fine hand in this, and believe me, I am going to find out when I see her today. Well, I wish you luck. Oh, that's probably Nina. I told her not to answer the phone, to give me a call.
Dr. Chuck Tyler here.
Hi, Chuck. It's Sybil.
Sybil? Yes, I'm fine. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm looking for Cliff. The desk said he might be there. Is he there by any chance?
Well, I just walked in. Now, why don't you let me check? She wants to talk to you. What do I say?
Shampoo and a grease conditioner. Together, they help you escape the greasy.
Escape the greasy with a grease. Clean your beard.
Escape. When was the last time you changed your mind? For example, chances are you buy Skippy peanut butter, and you probably think it tastes pretty good, and it does. But you know something? Peter Pan tastes better. In taste tests, 6 out of 10 people who thought they liked Skippy best like Peter Pan even better. Find out for yourself. After all, at these prices, why not pick the peanut butter you like best? Chances are, if you like Skippy, you'll love Peter Pan.
Wrong spelling.
Wrong word.
Wrong column.
Here, you can't go wrong with this. Erasermate 2 erases mistakes.
Pen that erases?
It's new, the 98-cent Erasermate 2. The pen that erases as easily as a pencil.
Wow, you can't go wrong with Erasermate 2.
It's new, Erasermate 2 from Papermate. Now for just 98 cents, you can't go wrong.
Tonight on Barney Miller, the precinct's new bulletproof vests may save lives, but their tailoring doesn't measure up to Harris's standards. And on Taxi, Louie's so jealous he's fit to be tied when Elaine moves in with Bobby. Brad hatches a plan to stop Jenny's wedding next. Watch One Life to Live following an ABC news brief.
Brought to you by Aquafresh. Now, Joe Templeton.
Good afternoon. The State Department and Pentagon both confirmed that North Korea fired a missile at a U.S. plane flying in South Korean and international airspace yesterday. They missed. The State Department says the U.S. views the incident with extreme concern and says such flights will continue. California officials have sprayed a Los Angeles suburb for medfly infestation. Parts of Oakland will be sprayed tonight. Now this.
Double protection Aquafresh. All the cavity-fighting fluoride of the leading paste, all the breath freshener of the leading gel, concentrated in one. Aquafresh fights cavities and freshens breath.
A new report says eating too much sugar may raise blood pressure and lead to heart disease. The report says too much sugar can raise the cholesterol level in blood. And former President Jimmy Carter, visiting China, got a chance to meet with his old friend, Vice Premier Deng Xiaoping. Mr. Carter joking that if Deng had been his running mate last year, Mr. Carter might have been reelected. That's News Brief. More on the ABC World News tonight.